Does anybody wonder what the future of physical retail stores is going to be in New Jersey and beyond? Hey there, NJ, Route22.com here with a question. Will shopping ever be the same? You know, our first thought is about this fear. What about all this fear and the big bad boogeyman monster? You know, you look around the real world. We drive around all the time. We're observing people. We don't see this big, giant crisis. I don't want to use the word, honestly. But if you look at the news, which I like to put in quotes, or official reports, they tell you a pretty darn scary story. And it appears that most people are buying into it. Doesn't seem like that to us. Everything seems perfectly fine, frankly. The shopping has dropped down considerably. And we're just wondering how that's going to affect things overall over the coming months and years. And we wonder, like, what would happen if they, I use they in quotes, the officials, the people who are telling everybody how to behave and think. What if they say things are okay? You know what? No big deal anymore. It's all done. Like, what percentage of the population will be forever afraid and will always wear masks and scared of touching things because they think there's some sort of bad germ on there? I mean, I see people wearing masks in 10 years from now, half the people are going to be wearing masks just like they do in Japan. But the business is really what I'm really thinking about. You know, oddly enough, I think you talk to any liquor store, they're doubling their month over month or month over year over year sales, double, 100% higher. And then, of course, the stores that were allowed to remain open, a lot of them, like Costco, for instance, their sales have gone down, at least in the gas section. You know, gas sales have tumbled, I think, half because nobody's going anywhere. But anyway, the scene behind me here is taken from one of these. It's the major strip mall in Clinton, New Jersey. It has a Walmart and a ShopRite and a TJ Maxx, which is closed. This cool scene you see behind me, it was taken with a newly acquired drone. I finally bought a drone that works, and it's pretty cool. And that's I'm gonna have a lot more of these backgrounds as you watch my videos. But anyway, the whole thing is, it's like the business model, I think, is going to be changed forever. And there's three, at least for the foreseeable near future, but there's three little factors in play here, in my opinion. Maybe four, but the fourth is more of an overall thing. The first thing is the property owners. These are people that own the buildings, and they charge rent, and they want tenants to pay, you know, the top rent or whatever the going market rate is for that region or area. And then you have the tenants who they have other things to factor in, like overhead. You know, I don't know, property owners, some people may own the property outright or pay mortgages, so they have to at least meet their mortgage payments and be able to pay for staff and so on, and maintenance and insurance and all that stuff. Everybody has overhead. But the tenants also, like the Walmarts and the small shops and the small business owners, all have overhead as well. And the amount of revenue they're getting, and that depends on whether the state allows people to shop or if they have a certain capacity limit. It's so stupid. It's beyond belief. And then, of course, the customers are the ultimate driver of all this, because without customers, you wouldn't have tenants, and you wouldn't have, the property owners would lose because they would just be sitting on a property that they have to pay taxes on and get no revenue at all. So to make this work, if everything is reduced, let's say consumer revenue is reduced or expenditure is reduced, somebody has to lose. And I should have said that customers will stop shopping at stores if prices go up. And prices normally go up when rents go up and so on. So there's this, it's a lot of nipping and tucking that has to go on. But someone has to lose. Someone's going to, if there's reduced expenditure at stores, maybe the loss has to be split equally, like, you know, slightly higher prices, lower revenue per store, and lower revenue for property owners. But I mean, who's willing to deal with that? At some given point in time, it becomes not worth it. So who knows? You know, I really don't know. But and of course, you have the general economy and whether people have jobs and have money to spend, as well as the online competition that's happening out there. It's easy just to click on your phone, you know, buy a thing on Amazon or whatever, Walmart or whatever it may be, Etsy or eBay even. I've been going to eBay a lot more lately because you get things faster, and it just seems like a lot of hustlers out there want to make a buck too. But will things ever get back to normal? That's the question. And I have a strange feeling, you know, unless somebody comes out and says, hey, the whole thing was a hoax and this was a waste of time, which, like I said, doesn't change how some people are going to be scared forever. But this drama is going to go on for the foreseeable future. I'd suggest at least, you know, a couple of years. So if you like the video, please hit the bell and subscribe and all that stuff. And I'll talk to you soon.